Welcome. My name is Dougram Bathbolt. I'm an economist at the Visa's Business and Economic Insights team. I'm here to share with you a new use case we developed for our Spending Momentum Index, which I think can be quite helpful in navigating uncertain economic times ahead. To start with, please note that this presentation is covered by our standard disclaimers. In particular, the views expressed here are of the Business and Economic Insights team and do not necessarily reflect those of the Visa executive management and affiliates. With that, let's get to the presentation. To start with, let's recall what Spending Momentum Index, or SMI, is, and more importantly, what information it can offer beyond other measures of consumer spending you may be more familiar with. SMI is our measure of how broad-based recoveries and downturns are in the consumer economy. Instead of asking by how much consumers are increasing spending, SMI provides an answer to how many of them are growing their spending. Conceptually, the index methodology is quite simple. For each credential we see in our network, we ask, did the consumer holding that credential increase spending this month relative to the same month a year earlier? If yes, we assign a score of 200. If spending remains stable on the card, we assign a score of 100. And if spending declined relative to the prior year, we assign a score of 0. When these scores are averaged across hundreds of millions of credentials in our network, we get an index that is centered around 100, with index values above 100 indicating net more consumers increasing spending relative to last year, and vice versa. What we find is that measured this way, SMI provides a more accurate and granular signal of consumer confidence, not only in their own financial situation, but also their ability to sustain spending growth going forward. So, starting in early 2022, the US SMI diverged from other measures of consumer spending, such as retail sales growth. Even though card purchase volume growth remains positive, SMI dropped well below 100, indicating a narrowing base for that PV growth and signaling a potential economic downturn ahead. If it comes, a recession in the US will not have an even impact on local and regional economies where your businesses operate. Case in point, during both the Great Recession and recent COVID recession, there were states that were able to buck the national trends and preserve positive economic growth even through a recessionary year. In fact, consumer spending growth in the best performing state was 7.5 percentage points higher than in the worst performing state at the depth of these recessions in 2009 and 2020. Such variation underscores the need to have a business strategy that is tailored to local economic conditions. What the chart on the left shows also is that such regional disparities are not anomalies. In fact, they represent rather a common pattern observed across all six most recent US recessions. We developed our SMI precisely to provide a more timely measure of consumer spending, not just nationally, but also locally, to better understand economic conditions driving our clients' business so that they can better react to the changing environment. What is more, it is no accident that we included the word momentum in the name of our index. Areas where SMI trends indicate stronger than average spending momentum tend to maintain that edge months into the future. Had our clients had access to our SMI at the beginning of the 2008 recession, they would have already seen emerging weaknesses in states like Florida and California, which resulted in a much weaker than average consumption growth in those states during the year, while anticipating relative resilience of local economies in states like Texas. Having access to SMI then could have provided an advance warning to businesses, helping them plan ahead, adjust acquisition plans, reallocate marketing budgets, or refocus areas for more risk monitoring. As we head into 2023, a common question we get from our clients is, can we provide an advanced signal of which regions are about to enter a recession? In other words, where can we expect an economic downturn that is more than just a temporary weak patch, but rather a pronounced slump in activity spanning multiple industries and indicators? At a national level, identifying recessions is conceptually easier, but much less straightforward at a state and local level, where there's often simply no comparable data to make such determination. One very useful indicator developed by an economist, Claudia Sam, is the change in the unemployment rate relative to the low of preceding 12 months. What she observed was that in all 11 US recessions since the World War II, shown as shaded areas on the left-hand side chart here, this indicator rose more than half a percentage point at the start of each recession, providing a very useful marker of the beginning of a recession, which we can extend to identify recessions at the state and even local levels. Defined this way, historical data shows two very useful insights about the relationship between national and regional recessions. First, regional recessions are much more common and always precede nationwide recessions, helping provide useful advanced warning to regional and local businesses well beyond the initially impacted areas. Second, even if business in your region is showing no signs of a possible recession ahead, note that economic downturns elsewhere in the country typically spread nationwide if regional recessions start impacting 10 or more states, or more than one in five cities. So early signs of an economic slump are more likely to emerge in your neighboring towns and states before showing up in your own backyard. Another question that we often receive from our clients is at what point any weakness they observe in their local SMI starts signaling elevated risks of a recession. We're pleased to introduce this new use case leveraging power and geographic granularity of our spending momentum indices to gauge recession probabilities at state and local levels. These probabilities leverage the totality of information available to us at such a granular level and summarize in an easy to understand and simple metric the likelihood of a local recession within the next 6 months implied by the SMI. Consider, for instance, what the model would have predicted as high and low recession risk cities in January of 2008. Our SMI-based measure would have helped businesses provide an early warning of economic weakness observed across cities in states such as California, Nevada, Arizona, or Florida, but equally important, help identify pockets of resiliency around states like Texas, Utah, or Colorado. The chart on the right here shows how employment growth trended through the rest of that year, showing clearly how jobs growth turned negative twice within the first 6 months among the high-risk cities, while low-risk cities maintained positive employment growth well through the end of the year, and only turned negative when the collapse of Lehman Brothers precipitated a global financial crisis that plunged the U.S. into its deepest downturn since the Depression era. Just as importantly as managing economic cycles on the way down, our recession probability measure can also help businesses catch the recovery as it happens, rather than reacting after the fact. Keep in mind that US recessions typically end within a year, and businesses earlier to restart marketing and acquisition campaigns can gain a strategic first mover advantage. Roll forward time to the June of 2009, for instance, when the US economy reached its lowest point of that recession. SMI implied probabilities then would have already identified early green shoots emerging in cities across the Plain States, such as Iowa, Nebraska, and the Dakotas. Businesses who have expanded their presence in these states and cities then could have enjoyed a much faster spending and revenue growth through the middle of 2010 relative to competition. You may be wondering what our more recent SMI say about the likelihood of a recession in your area. Let's start with the chart on the left, which provides the distribution of cities by recession probability risk over time. High-risk cities, colored in orange, typically are small in number during non-recession years, but the rise as a share of total during recessions. What is worrisome is that that ratio has risen and remains elevated in recent months, flashing a warning sign that broad-based slowdown may be ahead in manufacturing hubs like Ohio, as well as the rural Northeast, more vulnerable to higher natural gas prices needed to heat homes through the winter months. Conversely, cities in the Southwest generally show lower probabilities of a significant downturn, particularly in areas where the economy has a stronger concentration in recreation, education, and defense manufacturing industries. Overall, our recession probabilities based on the fourth quarter SMI readings indicate about 60% chance that US overall could enter into a recession in the first half of 2023. That takes us to the concluding slide of the presentation. I hope you'd found the information useful, and I would like to thank you deeply for your time.